The purpose of this hearing is to hear more about Sergeant Bo Bergdahl and his exchange for 5 terrorist prisoners from Guantanamo Bay. Let's hope that the Bergdahl negotiators are not the same ones currently negotiating with Iran over nuclear weapons. Be that as it may, releasing 5 senior Taliban commanders may put the lives of our senior service members and Americans around the world at risk. One of the 5 detainees was a deputy chief of the Taliban's intelligence service. One detainee fought alongside Al-Qaeda as a Taliban military general. Another was a senior commander wanted by the United Nations for war crimes and worked closely with Al-Qaeda and their affiliates. In fact, he led an attack with Al-Qaeda the day before 9/11. Al-Qaeda called this attack an important part of the 9/11 total strategy. And still another was a close confidant of Taliban leader Mullah Omar. The terms of the release to Qatar are quite disturbing. They may help out the Taliban while they are in Qatar, and it's very likely that all of them will end up fighting alongside the Taliban in Afghanistan later in the year. That will be about the time the United States forces will be leaving and the Afghans will be on their own. It appears that recent law that was signed by the President was violated in this secret deal. This law, among other things, requires 2 things: that the administration must notify Congress 30 days before releasing Guantanamo Bay detainees. And second, the administration has to specifically tell Congress how releasing each terrorist is in the national security interest of the United States. The administration did neither. Plus, it has been the policy of the United States not to negotiate with terrorists, and this seems to also have been violated. The Akhani Network are the ones who held Sergeant Bergdahl. It's a designated foreign terrorist organization, according to the United States State Department, and has killed countless Americans and Afghan soldiers. It maintains close ties with Al-Qaeda, and it's the most dangerous terrorist group fighting in Afghanistan. It doesn't matter that Qatar acted as a go-between the United States, but it did involve negotiating with terrorists in the Akhani Network. This raises another concern close to home in Texas. One of my constituents, Victor Lovelady, was taken hostage during the terrorist attack on an Algerian gas facility in January of 2013, an event that many Americans have forgotten. He was captured after he hid some of his co-workers in a space in the refinery. The terrorists never found the co-workers, and they eventually escaped alive. It's been reported that the hostage takers wanted to trade those three American hostages at the facility, including Victor, for 2 convicted terrorists in the United States custody. Victor's brother, Michael, and his daughter, Erin, wrote to me recently to say that they were told by our government during the attack that the United States does not negotiate with terrorists. Victor was later killed. I asked for unanimous consent that the letters be made part of the record. So ordered. The Bergdahl release troubled them, and rightfully so. Victor's daughter wrote to me in this letter, "The question that continues to come to mind is what makes one American life more important than another, and if we're going to negotiate for one, why would we not negotiate for everybody? I cannot answer that question. And I really do not know what the United States' current policy is on negotiating with terrorists. Maybe we will find out." Negotiating with a designated terrorist organization like we did with the Akhani Network is unprecedented. The Department of Defense says it will hold Sergeant Bergdahl accountable for his actions. However, National Security Advisor Susan Rice has said that Sergeant Bergdahl served with honor and distinction. Once again, this hearing will shed more light on that issue. And one of our witnesses today served with Sergeant Bergdahl, and he will discuss Bergdahl's disappearance. Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel is on record stating that he was not aware of any United States soldier who lost their life in search for Sergeant Bergdahl. The family of one of those brave Americans who gave his life, Lieutenant Darren Andrews, is here today to set the record straight. He earned the Silver Star for his actions, which included protecting his brothers in arms and taking the brunt of the Taliban rocket-propelled grenade, which ultimately took his life. Darren left behind a pregnant wife and a young son at the time of his death. So today we have witnesses who can tell us what else happened in eastern Afghanistan in 2009, those who have suffered as a result, and what this so-called deal may mean for Afghanistan and the United States going forward.